Good morning to all of you. In the last class, we have seen the property of the charge, and at that class we learned about the quantization of charge. Here I have written the three properties. That is the property of the electric charge. First is the quantization of charge that we have learned in the previous video and previous class. Now the second is the conservation of charge. Conservation of charge, and third is the like charge repel each other. So these three we have to know just now. One we have already studied, and the next is the conservation of charge. See the conservation of charge, what it says. The conservation of charge, it is in an isolated system. In an isolated system, the net charge is always constant. That is, the charge neither be created nor it can be destroyed. That is known as conservation of charge. We know, we have the knowledge of conservation of charge in case of energy also, that the net energy in an isolated system, in a universe, is always constant. That means energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but it can change from one form to another form. Similarly, the conservation of mass is also in chemistry. You will read that the mass before the reaction and after the reaction is the same. Likewise, here the charge is also conserved. Charge cannot be either destroyed or can be created. The net charge in an isolated system is always constant. Now, that means the conservation of charge we see here, that is the total electric charge. Total electric charge in an isolated system is always constant. Constant. That means, that is, charge can neither be created, charge can neither be created, nor it can be destroyed, nor it can be destroyed. The net value is always constant. And that is the conservation of charge. Now, how we come to know, how we understand this? So for that we take the some examples related with the conservation of charge. Now this, see the example for the conservation of charge. Suppose we have a relation, we have a reaction. That reaction is the uranium of 92-238. When it goes in the alpha decay, we know that the uranium is an acid, is an highly reactive atom, highly reactive element, that when we place it alone, it will decay in alpha, beta like this. So in the alpha decay, the result will be the thorium, and that thorium has the charge of 90 and the mass, atomic mass, is the 234. Plus, what happened about the other 4 and the 2? That will move in the helium 24. That is the alpha decay plus energy. This is the energy, or we write the energy. This is the reaction of radioactive substance, uranium. When react, what we observe here, before reaction the total charge is the 92. Before reaction, the net charge is or is equal to 92. Here is the charge value. Here is the mass value, atomic number, atomic mass. And after reaction, the net value is equal to 92 plus 2. That, sorry, 90 plus 2. 90 is here, plus 2 is here. That equal to, again, 90. Listen, student. Listen. The charge, whatever earlier, it is also the same after reaction also. Charge will not destroy. Charge will not change. Charge will not create it. Whatever earlier that remained in this isolated system, and that is the conservation of charge. One way we understand. Now another way, how we understand more about this conservation of charge, that is, let's see, here we have the two suitable element, two suitable material. That just for the frictional electricity, another example which we are considering, that is for frictional electricity. Now here, the two suitable elements, two suitable material, that is the, suppose this one is the one material and here it is the another material. When rubbed together with the suitable material, that means it is either glass or the silk or ebonite rod or the silk, that means there must be some suitability because between them, if we take whatever, on that case we will not get the frictional electricity. Now whenever you rub this one in the number of times, what we observe, few of the electrons from the one body, let it be the A, one body, and let it be the another body, will jump to the another body. That is the, or we can say that will move to another body and leaving behind the positive charge. That is the moves to another body. So what we observe, that before friction the net charge was the zero. Before, friction, the net charge is zero. Net charge is zero. Net charge is zero. Before friction, net charge is zero. Now, after friction, when they get the charge, and that charge is static. Static means it will not move. It will not go to one place to another place. That is, frictional, during the frictional electricity, whatever the charge produced, that charge lie at the one place, that charge lie at only that place where the friction occurred. And that is why it is known as static electricity. Static electricity. It is not moved. So, before friction, this is before friction, it is the value of the charge is zero. After friction, when we add these two, we have after friction the net value of the charge. Suppose the charge Q is equal to plus 2 plus minus 2, that equal to zero. Q is the net value. So after friction, net charge is zero. Net charge is equal to zero. What we come to the conclusion, what we understand here, the net charge is always conserved in an isolated system. It is the two particle system, and no other factor affect for the activities of this two particle system. That is called isolated system. So we come to know, we understand that the charge are always conserved whether we see in case of the reaction, whether we see in the case of static electricity, the net value of the charge never change. It always constant, and that is called conservation of charge. Now, third property is the like charge repel each other and unlike charge attract each other. It is very simple or very important also. Whenever you consider the like charge, that third property is the like charge repel each other. How it is so? That now understand how it is so, why the like charge, why unlike charge attract each other. Unlike charge attract each other. Now, how we understand this thing? So, just suppose this is the charge plus Q. That charge has its influence up to certain reason. Let it have the influence up to the certain reason, and that reason is called the electric field. That is called electric field. It is such a reason. Whenever the another will come on that is, suppose another charge for the Q, and for this charge it is small Q, Q naught. That comes in the region of the positive greater charge. It experiences a force due to the electric field, E vector. And that force is outward. That means here is the repulsion. The force is the repulsion. Likewise, if we consider the, in place of positive, if we consider the negative charge here, suppose here is the negative charge, minus Q naught. What we observe, the field is again here, and this will attract this one with the force, and this is called attractive force. Attraction, repulsion. With the like charge, there is the repulsion. That happens only due to the force acting here. For the positive, the force is equal to electric field to the charge Q naught. This is the factor, the electric field, the reason. Suppose I have the field. At that field, if any person will come, it is on me whether to welcome them or to refuse to welcome. Got my point? So it is the electric field reason for the charge Q, positive charge Q, which either see the like charge, on that case it do the repulsion. If it is unlike charge, that is the negative one, it will attract. So it is the one phenomena, one property, one character, one nature of the charge, that it either attract or repel the another charge, that depends upon the nature of the charge. That means like charge always repel each other and unlike charge always attract each other. So these three properties we have to learn in our class 10, but in senior class, in class 12, we will go for more properties of electric charge. In the next class, we see some behavior of the charge, and for that, you must be in contact with the video, with my lecture. Thank you.